After a traumatic brain injury, it's really very common for somebody to have difficulties with recognizing their own emotions, recognizing other people's emotions, expressing their emotions. This happens in somewhere between 30 and 70% of people after a brain injury, and this is really quite dramatic. So at the new IU Interface Center, we have brand new, very state-of-the-art technology that allows us to really look at the issues in a much more comprehensive and objective way than we have ever really been able to do before, to really better diagnose what are the issues. So the environment of the Interface Center is designed to be a natural observation laboratory. It's designed to study people in a very naturalistic setting. And this was done very purposefully because the deficits that we see after brain injury, when it comes to emotional problems, those emotional problems, they're happening when we're interacting with people. So it doesn't make sense to study these emotional deficits in isolation. It makes sense to study them as they are actually occurring, because that could give us a more realistic view, a better understanding about what's actually happening when people are at home talking with their family members or at work. So we are sitting in an area that very much looks like, should look like somebody's living room setting, so that we can then bring in a patient with a brain injury and their spouse or their mother or their son, and then have them communicate, just have a discussion with each other, just sit and talk. And we have these high definition video cameras that and microphones that can capture this interaction between two people, so that we can then take those, what we've recorded, and then analyze that in a very objective way, and very specifically look for very specific things during this interaction.
The thing that really excites me about the Interface Center is it took me back to my childhood when I was one of the, I remembered Star Trek when it first started, all right? I'm old enough to remember that. And I remember seeing Dr. McCoy, who was my favorite character, working with a patient in sick bay on a medical bed, and above him were all the physiological measurements, you know, the heart rate, blood pressure, and everything. And I remember thinking, how cool is that? I want to be able to do that. Well, here we come down the line a few years later, and now this is what it is. This is Star Trek. It's the reason I say that is because it's now wireless, and this is a fairly recent development. This is literally within the last year and a half that this has happened, is that we are able to actually do these measurements. We could do them before, but now we can do them wirelessly, and that encourages a more natural setting when individuals are just talking with each other and interacting, rather than having a million lines of wiring, you know, draping off of them. So in that sense, Star Trek has arrived. This is it.
So one of the neat tools that we have here at the Interface Center is this automated facial expression analysis software. And what we use this for is, so when we have the recordings of our patients' interactions that they did when they were in our living room center, we take these videos and we upload them to this software. And this software, this amazing software, will allow us to easily and objectively analyze our patients' facial expressions in a matter of minutes. So for example, here we have the video that we uploaded. And if we just press play, as you can see, the software is actually trying to grab the patient's face, and it's grabbing all the different muscles in her face in order to analyze her facial expressions. So there's a couple things we see on the screen here. Okay, so over here, this bar chart is constantly showing how much, to what degree, the patient is expressing neutral, happy, sad, angry, surprised, scared, and disgusted. So we can see on a moment-to-moment basis how much each one of those emotions is being expressed. Then down here, we are actually seeing to what degree the patient is experiencing either a negative or a positive emotion. So below anything below this line indicates neutral. Anything below the line, it's a negative emotion. Anything above the line, it's a positive emotion. And then this pie chart over here is indicating the average of each emotion that's expressed during the course of the video. And the cool thing about this is we can even put in for the face model, we can actually see, well, if you're working with a child, you can put in children. If you were working with an elderly patient, you can put in an elderly patient. So it could work better to analyze the type of face that is actually being processed by the system.